ages, who is Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, the only Savior of the world. Lord, even as we meditate upon those words, we are naked, we are poor, we are helpless, we are sinful, Lord. We can only depend on you, and we ask, Father, that you have mercy upon us. Have mercy upon us, knowing that our days are like breath that flies away, fleeting breath, O God. Like flowers, O God, that are here today and gone tomorrow. Lord, I pray in the name of Jesus that you minister to each one of us, O God. We want to commend ourselves before you. The Lord, you wash us clean by the precious blood of Jesus. That you help us, Lord, even in sorrow, in bereavement, in grief. The Lord, you minister comfort to us. You minister encouragement to us, O God. And Father, we shall find the solace in you. We surrender and we pray that your power shall dispel any other power that is not of your God. And your presence shall be with us as you comfort us, as you encourage us, as you speak to us. In words that are clear and still, that we shall understand you, that you minister to each one of us, especially the family. The Lord, at the end of it all, we shall find our benefit in you. We give you thanks and praise, for we pray, believing and trusting in Jesus Christ, our Lord and our Savior. Amen. Once again, you're very welcome, and on behalf of the cathedral, I want to welcome you. My name is Betty Mutoni Mwanda. By God's grace, I'm one of the ministers here at the cathedral. And we want to welcome each one of you in your various capacities. Feel very welcome. All protocol is observed. The Lord be with you. The Lord Jesus Christ said that I am the resurrection and I am the life. He who believes in me, though he die, yet shall live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. And friends, God is our refuge and strength, an ever-present help in time of trouble. He is the one who comforts all that are bereaved, and he's comforting us even right now. We know very well that at the tomb of Lazarus, he mourned with the people. He wept because he feels for us. So our encouragement is he has gone through the cares of this world. He understands it and he's standing with us. Praise the Lord. I want to invite us to read from Psalm 90. Psalm 90, if you have your Bible, please open there and we shall read together. Psalm 90, together. Lord, you have been our dwelling place throughout all generations. Before the mountains were born, oh, you brought forth the whole world. From everlasting to everlasting, you are God. You turn people back to dust, saying, return to dust, you mortals. 1,000 years in your sight are like a day that has just gone by, or like a watch in the night. Yet you sweep people away in the depth of death. They are like the new grass of the morning. In the morning it springs up new, but by evening it is dry and withered. We are consumed by your anger and terrified by your indignation. You have set our iniquities before you, our secret sins in the light of your presence. All our days pass away under your wrath. We finish our years with a mourn. Our days may come to 70 years or 80 if our strength endures. Yet the best of them are but trouble and sorrow, for they quickly pass and we fly away. If only we knew the power of your anger, your wrath is as great as the fear that is in your due. Teach us to number our days, that we may gain a heart of wisdom. Relent, Lord, how long will it be? How compassion on your servants. Satisfy us in the morning with your unfailing love, that we may sing for joy and be glad all our days. Make us glad for as many days as you have afflicted us, for as many years as we have seen trouble. May your deeds be shown to your servants, your splendor to their children. May the favor of the Lord our God rest on us. Establish the work of our hands for us. Yes, establish the work of our hands. Glory be to God the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. We will affirm our faith by the words of the Apostles' Creed, which I believe that many of us know by heart, but also hopefully the sound team can project it for us. Apostles' Creed together. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, He rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. And the choir will give us a song as we offer. We will offer, we will have the sharing from God's word, then the laying of the wreaths and the speeches will come later. Let us have a song later.
Amen.
pray, believing and trusting in Jesus' name. Amen. Welcome once again. I want to invite a member or two of the family to join Brother the Vajra, Brother Emmanuel Unenboth, to be able to count his money. As our culture, as All Saints Cathedral Kampala, we make a contribution that helps the family in the funeral expenses. So please join Emmanuel so that we can be able to have this done. Thank you very much. Good afternoon once again. The Lord is good and all the time, and that is his nature. Let's give him a clap. Yes, even in death, he is God. Even in bereavement, he is good. He never changes. I already mentioned to us that God the Father sent God the Son, and God the Son witnessed all the troubles that we go through this world, including death. He experienced it. So he knows exactly what we go through in such a time as this. But also we thank God that his Holy Spirit is with us when we believe in him, when we trust in him, and his Holy Spirit comforts us. One of the roles of the Holy Spirit is a comforter. Hallelujah. The Holy Spirit is a comforter. So God understands that in this world we go through troubles. And so he has not left us alone, but he has left us with his Holy Spirit to comfort us, to guide us, to see us through such challenging moments. So I invite us to share from scripture. We are going to look at the psalm that we read, Psalm 90. Psalm 90 is a psalm of Moses. Moses, a man of God. Moses, a friend of God. And it highlights three main things. One is that God is eternal. He has existed from eternity. And the other thing that the psalm highlights is that there are many troubles, many challenges that we go through, including death, like we're experiencing now. But also, there are requests, there are areas to focus on, asking God to help us. And so as we share, that God will speak to each one of us. We are not speaking to our father, our friend who has passed on, because he's not hearing. But it's you and me that need his message. And I've titled the message, Eternity. Eternity, God is eternal, and he says those who believe in him, even when they die, what will happen to them? They will live. So we also enjoy eternity with him. But there is a condition that we will see as we continue. So we've seen in verses 1 and 2, God being described by Moses, his friend, as our dwelling place. Throughout all generations, God is our dwelling place. Just imagine, I would say talk to your neighbor, but because of distance, maybe it may be difficult. But is God your dwelling place? Is God my dwelling place? If he is, that is very good, because there is security. There is security with God in our midst. There is forgiveness with God. There is every good thing with God. He has existed from the beginning to the end. He will always be God. And so you and me need to have a personal relationship with God Almighty. A personal relationship that he has provided for us to enjoy the abundant life that he speaks about in John chapter 10, verse 10b, that Jesus Christ came that we may have life and
life in its fullness, life in abundance. I know many of us, if not all of us, we want good life, isn't it? We want abundant life. But that abundant life that doesn't just come like that. It comes with us connecting with God. Because we know we are fallen human beings, our ancestors sinned, and we also sin. We cannot claim that we have not sinned, as the Bible says. If we do so, then we deceive ourselves and God's truth is not in us. But we also claim to make God a liar, and yet He is always truthful. So my encouragement and challenge to us is that we may hide ourselves in God that dwells in bliss. That even when we go through the challenges of this world, we will know that He is our present help in times of need. He is with us at all times. Now, the second part, looking at the series of the challenges from verse 3 to 11, there are many that have been mentioned. Verse 3 says, "You turn people back to dust, saying, 'Return to dust, you mortals.'" Verse 5 says, "Yet you sweep people away in the sleep of death. They are like the new grass of the morning. In the morning it springs up new, but by evening it is dry and withered." So many of the challenges that Moses recounts, we experience similar challenges. We go through them as individuals. We go through the different challenges as families. The family of the late Honorable BWAMBALE are going through this challenge now that the dear one is no more. And all of us are associated with him. We feel grief, we feel pain, would have wished to live longer. Thank God for him, he has lived a bit of time. This time is in the hands of God. He decides how long each one of us is to live. But even this long life, the scripture mentions that all our days pass away under God's wrath, that we finish our years with a moment, you know? For a few, if I recall well, is honor and of the scriptures that we are told he did not pass through death. He walked with God and God took him alive. But for many of us, we end in death. Perhaps you as a person, as you go through sickness and disease, there is that pain, there is that mourn. But even when you go, your dear ones face the challenges. But there is the bigger challenge, friends, because it's appointed that we will all die, apart from the few like Enoch and many others whom will be alive when our Lord Jesus Christ returns. Now let's look at verse 8. Verse 8 says, "You have set our iniquities before you, our secret sins in the light of your presence." What are some of the secret sins that we know? Those that people may not see, people may not understand, but you're committing a sin. For instance, if a lady commits fornication or adultery, there's a possibility of evidence. If conception takes place, a stomach will protrude, and people will say, "Oh, this one is not married. How come she's expecting?" That is a clear way of a sin that is common. Or perhaps you steal and you're caught, but there are some who are not even caught. And these days, there are very smart ways of turning figures and you steal money. People may notice after a long time. But be sure your sin rulers find out. That's what the scripture says. But there are these secret sins, such as envy. When I envy my neighbor, even my closest friend will not know unless I bring it out. What about hatred? Many times we live in hatred because of the situations that we go through. Someone might have spoken something and you feel, how could she, how could he, who is she, who is he to speak to me? And we pick a quarrel with them, we hate them. There are many others. The jealousy, because so and so has so much which I don't have. We are envious, we are jealous of them. But there could be many other sins that are secret. But even that secret, my friend, God knows it, because He is the Creator, He is Almighty, He is all-knowing, He knows everything. Here on earth, we can be celebrated as heroes, and that is okay. We thank God for the lives that we live, for the different contributions that we make. Each one of us in our various engagements, we've made a contribution, haven't we? We have made a contribution in this world, either in the political arena, in the social arena, any other arena. Economics, you are a good business person. Perhaps you're very religious and you're making a contribution. But all this will avail to nothing if we do not turn away from our sins, including those secret sins that nobody knows. This portion talks about the suffering. And if we do not turn to God and repent of these sins, we will have double tragedy, double suffering. Suffering here on earth, but also suffering in eternity. We know there is heaven and there is hell, but we have to choose. If we are to go to heaven and live with God for eternity, we need to turn away from our sins. But if we live in our sins and continue, then we are choosing the path of eternal destruction, eternal suffering. My brothers and sisters, I pray that God will help us to be sincere with ourselves. Only you and God know the state of your heart. Know those things that you do in private. Perhaps you are a married person, but you're cheating on your spouse. You had cases of people saying, I'm going for a trip, I'm going for a workshop, but actually that workshop is with somebody else's wife or somebody else's husband or somebody who is not their legally wedded spouse. Those are tricks of the devil. We live in this world, and yes, we are all vulnerable to those temptations. But my prayer and encouragement to us is that Jesus Christ overcame sin, he overcame temptations. The Bible says he was tempted in every way, just as we are, but he did not sin. Hallelujah. He was tempted in every way, just as we are, but yet he was without sin. And he's the only one who has a solution for sin. You and me deserved the punishment. The scripture is saying that we pass away under the wrath of God. Jesus Christ took that wrath. He suffered on the cross for our sins. He suffered that we may not suffer again when we accept Him as our Lord and our Savior. But if we do not, then we are opening ourselves for eternal destruction. God is a loving God. He is also a just God. He loves a sinner, but he hates sin. God loves you and me as sinners, but he hates the sin. So in response, we need to denounce the sin that God hates so that we can restore our relationship with him, that we can enjoy the love that he gives, and this life is free of charge. We do not pay anything. The only way to access it is by acknowledging that we are sinners, that we have wronged God, and that we want to put our relationship with him. And the last part that we want to talk about is the counsel that we are given to be able to pray, to be able to return to God, to be able to be honest with ourselves and ask God to help us. Verse 12 says, teach us to number our days, that we may gain a heart of wisdom. Teach us to number our days, that we may gain the heart of wisdom. As we mentioned, verse 10 says, our days may come to 70 years or 80 if our strength endures. Yet the best of them are but trouble and sorrow, for they quickly pass away and fly away. We thank God for the life of the late Honorable BWAMBALE, that he has lived for over 90 years. That's a bonus, isn't it? According to the scripture, according to the statistics, our life expectancy is not that long. So let's thank God for a life that has been lived well and has been lived long. That our friend who lies here has lived this long. And for some people, they say it runs in the blood. So perhaps you young men and women, the family members, you may have this long life. But whatever the number of days, the scripture is teaching us that we need to ask God to teach us how to number our days, how to live purposefully. When I go, what am I going to be remembered for? What will people say? Sometimes we concoct speeches. I'm not mentioning about this one. The ones that are coming, I guess they are going to be real. But we want to speak so well about a person that has passed on. But whether we are speaking and cementing the speeches, friends, if your life has not been hidden in the Lord Jesus Christ, if your life has not been of repentance and walking right with God, these are here on earth. But the real critical thing is about eternity. How and where will you spend your eternity? Think about it. How and where will you spend eternity? Is it with God the Father forever in enjoyment? Is it in eternal suffering, burning all the days of your life? The choice is for each one of us. But as we choose, verse 14 says, satisfy us in the morning with unfailing love, that we may sing for joy and be glad all our days. May it be our prayer that the Lord will satisfy us with his unfailing love, that we will choose to love him and live our days in celebration, that we may enjoy his favor, that we will be glad as we live this life on earth. May we ask the Lord to guide us, that we will enjoy eternity here on earth, the good life he brings, but we shall also, we'll enjoy good life here on earth, but we'll also enjoy eternal life with the Father, with the Son, and with the Holy Spirit, as we live our lives carefully, as we live lives of repentance, lives that serve the Lord. So I'll invite each one of us to reflect for a moment. What is God speaking to you right now? The Bible tells us the Holy Spirit of God convicts us, the world, of sin, of righteousness and judgment. Sin that when we do not repent, the wages of sin is death and will be destroyed. But of righteousness, that when we repent and turn from our sins, then there is eternal life, which is a free gift of God through Jesus Christ. But also judgment, if we do not repent, then we shall suffer forever. Pray prayer as a person and ask the Lord to help you. If you've not given your life to Christ, if you're not confessing Him as your Lord and Savior, today is an opportunity. Today is a moment. I'll just sing a short chorus as we pray, as we meditate. God sent His Son, Jesus. He died on the cross. He died on the cross for us, and He rose again to have our sins forgiven and give eternal life. Don't you go without Jesus. Don't you wait for tomorrow. Don't you wait until Jesus comes back. Don't you go without Jesus. And my sisters, don't you go without Jesus. Don't you wait. Thank you very much. I'd like now to invite a member of the family to help us. We work out the laying of the wreaths and then the few speeches that we have agreed on. Someone to assist in the laying of the wreaths, a few of them perhaps, if there are many, the others can be acknowledged. And then we will have the family speak and the other members that we agreed. The family is traveling, so we pray that the Lord will help us to be quick at that and that everything shall go well. Thank you. The choir can give us a song as we prepare to do this. Bless you.
Popularly known as Ibete, who was the first Mkonzo speaking MP and the first Mkonzo speaking minister, and who served this country diligently. We are now going to the second part of this service, where we are going to lay the wreath on the late BWAMBALE. We shall be calling people one by one. I'm standing in for the MC and also as a member of the family. I am called Kabianga Godfrey Baruku Chine. I'm the Minister of State for ICT and National Guidance, in charge of National Guidance, but this old man laying here is my maternal uncle, so I'm also a member of the family, so we perform all duties. I would now like to invite the children. I think whoever will come to lay the wreath, then he also makes a speech because we are time back. So let me now invite the children. A plus say we first finish that function of the wreath and then we go to speeches. That one is okay. Let us start with the children, because they are the main people in this function. All the children of the late Ezron Ibamba. Let's now have the political leadership of Kasese, and I think they should be led by one of our senior politicians, Honorable Nsamizi. I can see Honorable Hero and Honorable Centenary are all here. The political leadership is except Dr. Chionga, because for him we can't be here in another capacity. Honorable Centenary, Honorable Behande, and Honorable Behande are also here. Honorable Swambala has led this team because he's the fourth who also speaking minister of government since this act was created. And then we shall have the grandchildren. Then we shall have Charles Hall. Kasese community which resides in Kampala. I think I saw Norman must be one of the senior guys here. Norman is single man. Can I lead that team? we have the last, which will be led by the Honorable Dr. Chionga, who is outgoing ambassador to China and the member of the Central Executive Committee of the ruling National Resistance Movement and representing government. Once again, I thank you, Reverend, for leading this sermon and for the word of God. And once again, I welcome you, all dignitaries, honorable MPs who are here, our chief mourner now, right now, Honorable Dr. Chionga, our former minister and MP, Honorable BWAMBALE, and the rest of protocol observed. Let me now, in the interest of time, invite the children to come and give their speech. Thank you very much.
Up to 80 years, he lived up to 93. So That's amazing. Yeah, so I said parents live forever. They live with their children, within, around, and we have beautiful memories that we will always remember. He had kids, he served his country, and he contributed to our district success. So I think Bwambale will always be remembered in so many ways. So thank you again. I don't have much to say. I can go on, but it's so many things I can say about him. If I'd prepared, maybe it would be more. I didn't, but just to give you a glimpse of his life and how our home is. He was quite a very charismatic and humoristic person, and that is again seen in his children, grandchildren, and great-grandchildren. So we are so blessed, and we are going to celebrate his life. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Yeah, those were the children of the late Honorable Izron Bwambale. Without wasting time, let me invite Honorable Harold Tone, the MP for Bukonzo East, where the Honorable resides, to represent the political leadership, and he will also introduce the rest of the political leaders over here.
Thank you so much. Take this opportunity to give thanks to the Almighty that today a person who was born in the 1920s, those years of the 1920s, we still see him so very much alive to the modern times, to the current times. This means that the saying I've always heard, that when you see a very green compound, just know that behind it is a very big water wheel. The fact that the life of the Honorable Bwambale can be celebrated at this level today, it means that behind the scenes, there is a lot that has happened. It's the reason why I want to thank the family. I want to thank the family for which he raised. And in turn, you have supported him to live up to the age of the 90s. I am sure it wasn't because of his charisma that you have probably talked about here, but because he impacted it in the children, and the children have translated it into a role. I recently found a book which is very interesting, because we have been always read books of how parents will raise their children. But there is an interesting book of how children will raise their parents. And I think this is a testimony. The church, I want to thank you so much for taking us through this service that is preparing us to go home. We want to celebrate the life of Bwambale. My name is Mhindo Harold Tony, representing the people of Bukonzo East in the 11th Parliament. I am currently the chairperson of the members of Parliament coming from Kasese, but for today you allow me to speak and bring on board all the other members of Parliament that were in the other parliaments where I am not chair. I therefore want to recognize the presence of our most senior, the Honorable Dr. Christmas Chionga. I recognize the fact that you are representing the government, but as a member of Parliament, I want to recognize your presence. I recognize the presence of the Honorable Louis Bwambale, who is with us here, Mr. Chairman, and the Minister at that time, for Jena, and Women Affairs. I recognize the presence of the Honorable You pass the hand to BWAMBALE. And also recognize the presence of his wife, but also Honorable District Woman Member of Parliament, Honorable Peter Wilson. I recognize the presence of the Honorable Robert Franco Centenary, Assistant Municipality. I have apologies of other members who have not been with us, but they will be with us at the other function in Kasese, the Honorable Stanyasowe, the Honorable Atkins, the Honorable Kapale Therigo, the Honorable Mujungu. We shall be with them at the function at home. We really want to thank the Honorable BWAMBALE because he's our banker as politicians, the pathfinder. We will always refer to the path he took because it is in his footsteps that we are following. We will be speaking much more probably while at home, but I want to recognize the fact that government is aware that BWAMBALE worked for this government. We have been in different corners as a team, the team that I have mentioned, and they know that yes, BWAMBALE worked for his government. When I went to the office of the clerk, he told me the people who sat in the LEGCO, we had three surviving members, and you are coming to tell me about the death of the late BWAMBALE. I had received a communication from the Honorable Dr. Chionga. But also just yesterday, they told us the other second surviving person from the East also had died, just the same time. But in all, it is really an indicator that government knew that these people who contributed a lot to this country were still living and they were able to locate them and know the worth and the importance of their contribution to this country. I want to thank you. We shall speak more well at home, but I encourage that we will start with the family until this process is finished. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much, the Honorable Tony. Let me now invite myself. The MC inviting himself. As now Minister of Government, the Reverend who took us to this service with the Minister, Reverend, the Honorable Dr. Chionga, member of SEC, and outgoing Ambassador to China, and the very senior Minister, MP, and politician, the Honorable Louis Wambare, the Honorable Leader, former Leader of Opposition, Willy Kiza, and the Honorable Mihande, Honorable Centenary, all of you. You are welcome to this important service when we are sending out one of us. And all of you, the community in Kasese, staying in Kampala. The Honorable BWAMBALE was a minister, like you. But me, I'm an ex-official member of parliament. But for him, he also became a full member of parliament. He was the first Mkonzo speaking person who joined Parliament. He joined it as a LEGCO. There were only 110 who went to Rangastan to negotiate for independence. And he was among those 110. Very historical. When he came back, he stood as a member of Parliament. In LEGCO, he was representing an area called Torosau. When he came back, and now they were constituting parliament after independence, he represented Busongola County as an MP. And I've always asked him how he won the elections, because he was standing against a very powerful man, one of the most learned Makonzo who has ever lived, and who people don't know, Timothy Bazaragusa, the first Ugandan High Commissioner to London. He came from London to come and start with the Honorable Wambale, who had just completed junior secondary school. And I always asked him, how did you teach him? He told me, Timothy was a Rahusa, he knew how to dust the local dust. So when they were running, they said, okay, you dust the local dust. And it was a trick by the Honorable Wambale. And the team was a Barabusa couldn't dust the local dust. And they said, no, this one is one of us. He knows how to dust. Because Barabusa had grown up in London, he had studied in Budo like Dr. Giova. And this was a man who was just from junior secondary school, but he had a good command of English. The red Wambale you see here used to speak very fluent English. And people made him a member of parliament. Later on he crossed, he was on DP ticket. Later on he crossed from DP to UPC on the floor of parliament. And the late His Excellency Milton Obote made him deputy minister of culture and community development in charge of refugees. So Wambale was the first Mugonzo speaking minister. The second is the late Amos Waziri, and the third is this great man you see here, Honorable Chief. The fourth is Honorable Lois Wambale, and the fifth is Honorable Chivata, and the sixth is the man who is talking. So you can see how our history is very short. How our history is very short. I'm the sixth minister of government. When other communities have the 100, our history is short, and that's why this man you see here is very, very important to us. Very important. He was a jolly man. Very jolly man. In Kasese, he is credited for having convinced the Baptist Church to establish a hospital in Kagano. Because those Baptists were in Wecha, and all the people who had leprosy were walking up to Wecha. And he's the one who used to take them there as a representative of the district commission. Because he worked in the district commissioner's office. So he convinced them that my people are suffering. Come and establish a hospital in Kagano. And they came and established a hospital in Kagano. And those are some of the things why he was elected MP. He's also credited for Mubuk irrigation scheme, the biggest irrigation scheme in this country up to now. He's also credited for Mubuk prisons. And that's where the controversy is. People say Wambale brought a what? A prison. And when I grew up, I was also asking myself, why did Wambale bring a prison? And I went to him, because it's my arm. Said, my arm, of all things you brought a prison. He said, yes. I asked him why. He said, in the 60s, during the West Room, which you hold, the Makasule School became rebellious. And they were always arrested and taken to the country. And many of them died there. Because nobody could walk Fortportal to see them. Nobody would even get representation. So he said, my people are very rebellious and they don't please to come here. Let me take a prison here. So that whenever they get problems, they arrested Jack and kept here. Where someone can walk and see them and where they can get representation. And I said, that was the best an MP would do at that. Otherwise, so many people lost their lives in Katwe. Their bodies have never been retrieved. Their cases have never been heard. But as soon as the prison was put in Mubuk, everything became easy. And eventually, people started getting representation. And we didn't lose any other rebellious people in Katwe anymore. That's one thing. But also, you should know that he has survived the death several times. Both natural death and murder and assassination. May your soul rest in peace. Let me now take the opportunity to now invite myself again to the MC and now take the opportunity to invite the Honorable Dr. Chionga, member of Central Executive, the outgoing ambassador to China, to come and now speak on behalf of the government. Thank you, my man.
And the former deputy minister of the NRM government, Honorable Makasule BWAMBALE EZIRON, former district chairperson of for Kasese District, and also former Member of Parliament from Counsellor East. Honourable Mrs. Kiza Hande, former leader of the opposition in the Ugandan Parliament, and also former woman Member of Parliament for Kasese. I also recognize the presence of my brother, Centenary Robert, who is also with us. I also mention in absentia our colleagues who are not here, Honorable Soweli Tanywa, Busongola North, Honorable Atkins Sabe, Konzo West, Honorable Florence Kabuo, the current Kasese District Woman MP. The reason I mention them as well within absentia will be clear as I progress with this communication. The children and other members of the family of the late Honorable Ezirone Wambale, the clergy, Honorable Mutoni, and those who are assisting you, the civil servants hailing from Kasese but who live here and work here, members of the business community, friends and fellow Ugandans. On behalf of His Excellency Yoweri Museveni, President of the Republic of Uganda and Chairperson of the National Resistance Movement, and on my behalf and that of my family, I bring deeply felt condolences following the passing on of Mzee Ezirone Wambale. The message goes to the following, this message of condolence. Goes to our mothers, surviving mothers, Mrs. Kabatooro Wambale and Mrs. Teddy Wambale. The message goes to all the offsprings of Mzee Ezirone Wambale, the children, the grandchildren, and the great-grandchildren. The message goes to all the relatives of them of Mzee Wambale, and all the people of Kasese District and the Renzori sub-region. President Museveni has sent through me a contribution of 10 million shillings as a contribution to the burial expenses. Mzee Wambale, as you've heard, was the deputy minister in the Obote I government and was also the MP at that time for the whole area covering present day Kasese more or less. And that's the reason I was mentioning the other MPs who are not here with us. One person was covering that area, now it is covered by six MP. Honorable Kabianga said the Mzee Wambale was the first Mugonzo speaking minister. We need to check because the Wakons are here, they're also in Congo. So we need to know whether that side also they hadn't had the minister by that time. But you make a good point that given the history of Uganda, that shows that our development is quite recent. President Museveni knew Mzee Ezirone personally. At the time, Mzee Ezirone was deputy minister. Later on, before the overthrow of Obote I government, President Museveni was a youth. He had just finished university in Dar es Salaam and was working in the president's office. So he knew Mzee Ezirone. And I think recently he met him hardly 3-4 years ago. There is a time former ministers came to be honored in parliament, and Mzee Wambale made it, came here, and had a one-to-one with President Museveni. So President Museveni decided by his passing on, and he sends us that message of condolence as I have communicated. Mse Ezron, we pay tribute to him for great leadership, as we've heard in the messages that have been communicated before. But in addition, we also pay tribute to him because he was naturally a peace lover. He never wanted disturbance of the peace. So if we pay tribute to him for that leadership and also for peace, then it is our duty in the remembrance of this day that each one of us, wherever we are, within our different capacity, we should do whatever we can to sustain peace and security in our country. That is important. With peace, with stability, then you have the possibility of moving forward to the path of development and social economic transformation. So in this regard, I think we note with satisfaction the work being done by the heroic forces of Uganda and the DRC in pursuing the ADF terrorists in the jungles of the DRC. In other words, I completely share with you what he loved, what he worked for, what he liked, peace. These sons of Congo, the sons of Uganda, are looking for by pursuing those terrorists in the jungles of the DRC. As I was coming here this morning, I also got a message from the Speaker of Parliament, the Right Honourable Jacob Olanya, as you heard from Honourable Bell. He's with you, the family, he's with us, the people of Kasese, in this sorrow, as we bid farewell to Mzee. The message is written, and we'll be able to hand it to the family. But in the interest of time, I summarize by indicating that he concludes his communication by, on behalf of the Parliament of Uganda, also contributing 10 million shillings as a contribution to the value of expenses of late Mzee Bwambale. As I conclude, therefore, I say to Mzee Ezron, who is laying before us, whose illustrious life we are celebrating, much as we are sad, that we pray, as Reverend Tony reminded us many times, we can only pray that you, Almighty God, this good man, this leader of ours, we want to find him when we come to you. And we want to come to you in eternity and also sit on the right hand of God where Jesus is. That's where we pray that you keep on say Ezron Bwambale. Thank you all of you for coming and for listening to this message. Thank you very much.
We can give a bigger hand clap. Thank you very much, Honorable Kabianga and Honorable Kiunga, for those good remarks and for all the people that have spoken. We pray that those words will be impactful. And again, the challenge is, what will you be remembered for and where will you spend? Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Once again, I want to thank you all very, very much for coming, for identifying with our family, for the wonderful remarks. And thank you for giving. And we've been able to make a contribution of 954,000 Uganda shillings. Shy of a few shillings to make it 100,000, I mean a million shillings, and this will be handed over to the family to assist them in the funeral expenses. Let me have a family member to sit down. Thank you, our choir. Thank you, the sound team. Thank you, A+. Thank you, all the media houses that are here. Thank you, everyone, for coming and want now to pray in conclusion that the Lord will guide us and continue to remind us of how to spend our eternity. So I want to ask all the children of the late Honorable BWAMBALE to stand. And we're going to pray for them. Stand where you are, we don't have enough space, but also because of social distancing, they will stand and we're going to stretch our hands to them. Pray for them that the Lord will continue to comfort them, God will continue to strengthen them, and God will continue to be their present help in such a time of need. Father God, we thank you that you're almighty, you are from eternity to eternity. Lord, we thank you for all that you have shared in this place. Thank you for the good memories about the Honorable BWAMBALE who is lying in his death here. We pray that, Lord, you continue to minister to this family. We pray for these that are standing here as a point of contact, that, Lord, you encourage them. Father, may you comfort them. May you strengthen them. May you be with them, O Lord. And for all the people that will be traveling, Lord, we pray that you grant them generosities, that you will be there for them, O God, that you will support them. And Lord, even as they go through all the arrangements for the send-off, finally, the Lord will be with them. Give you thanks, we give you praise, for it's in Jesus' name that we pray. Amen. Amen. So let me invite all of us now to stand as we pray in conclusion. My brothers and sisters, may the Lord bless you. May the Lord cause his face to shine upon you. May the Lord grant you favor before himself and before other people. May the Lord grant you his peace that surpasses all understanding to guard your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus. May the Lord continue to be gracious to you and all of us. And may God, the Father, God, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, the Lord, whose blessings may reach and add no sorrow. May he bless each one of us. May he continue to remind us of eternity, that we will live with him in this world and for eternity. This we ask. God, our Father, you will bless each one of us. Bless us now and forevermore.
Amen.
And the Lord bless each one of you who wish you generosities. Wish you God's comfort. Let the choir sing.
As a leader,
Come. abirina ebyo byononya abirina azirina sente zoyika yesu azirina amulino mubezo mwesimbu kwononya amulina kwe mugambe nti wano na wano tata wawawonya ngomutima guluma nesanyu tofuna ngamanyi gabula nesubi tolaba mugambe nti wano wano tata we waluma mugambe nti wano na wano tata wawawonya